Hello. We got a lot of serious news this week. We got basketball. It's been going on all week. We also have interesting topics, such as, should women be in combat? Hello. This is the RBC, and today is February 1st, 2013.
Man, I hope this teacher isn't lame like the other ones.
What is it, Wayne?
You've had something on your shirt all day. It's been bugging me.
Oh.
RBC.
Recently, animal attacks have been on the rise. 58-year-old John McKay thought he'd been hit by a brick. Apparently, a large bird of prey, around 2 feet tall, knocked him in the ground and attacked the back of his head Saturday evening. This happened just outside the Masonic Club on Gordon Terrace around 9:15 p.m. McKay went into shock after the eagle owl sliced the back of his head, causing heavy bleeding. He said, "I thought I had been hit on the back of the head by a brick. I didn't hear a thing, not the flap of a wing. It was only when I stumbled back onto my feet when I saw the owl perched atop the van out of the corner of my eye. Then I knew what had happened." In North Miami Beach, two lemurs got loose and scratched a 2-year-old girl in the face. The girl was treated at the scene and wasn't hospitalized. Officers were able to capture one of the lemurs after it had jumped on top of a police car. The owner was able to catch the other lemur. 68-year-old James Campbell died suddenly when a dog jumped into a van and pushed on against the accelerator, causing the vehicle to strike the man as he opened the gate outside his home.
Hi, do you play an instrument, or have you ever wanted to learn how to play an instrument?
Yeah, I play an instrument.
Have you always wanted to be in a band?
Yeah, I've always wanted to play in a band.
Well, you should join the Tipton-Rosemark Academy Praise Band called... We practice every day during lunch, except for Fridays, day off. Come try out, and I promise, it's a lot of fun.
On the 24th of January, 2013, the ground combat exclusion policy was lifted, meaning both men and women are eligible to serve in frontline combat and complete combat operations. The Ground Combat Exclusion Policy of the United States Army dates back to 1994, when the Pentagon declared, "Service members are eligible to be assigned to all postings for which they are qualified, except that women shall be excluded from assignments to units below the grade level whose primary mission is to engage in direct combat on the ground." In November, the American Civil Liberties Union sued the Pentagon on behalf of our female service members concerning the combat exclusion policy, claiming that women already are serving in direct ground combat, but not receiving proper training or recognition as their male counterparts. Sunday, a nightclub in a small college town in southern Brazil caught on fire. 230 people were killed, at least 100 of them being students from the Federal University of Santa Maria. The students and other young people were there to hear a band perform. The blaze may have been caused by fireworks or a flare held by a performer. Toxic smoke quickly filled the club, causing panic. Firefighters had trouble getting inside due to bodies partially blocking the doors. The university stated on its website that all international exchange students, with the exception of one, had been found safe.
You can stop by the high school office to get sign-up forms and more information on the 2013 Sweetheart Pageant to benefit March of Dimes, which will be taking place on Saturday, February 16th. Any high school students that wish to play tennis must have your physical and paperwork completed before tryouts on Monday, February 11th. And also, middle school will be having a semi-formal Valentine's dance Saturday, February 9th in TRA TAC from 7 to 10, and the tickets are $15. Ethics Club will be holding a meeting in Coach Scott's room every Thursday at 11:40. And let's not forget about the middle school and high school Bible studies. Every Tuesday and Thursday, there will be a high school Bible study in room 111 at 12:05. Middle school will be having a similar Bible study every Thursday morning at 7:20 in Miss Porter's room. And from Thursday, April 4th to Sunday, April 7th, TRA Spring Musical South Pacific will be performing, and you should definitely be sure to go see it. Thursday, student show will be showing at 9 a.m. and again at 7 p.m. Friday will be showing at 7 p.m., Saturday at 3 and 7, and then again for the last time on Sunday at 2 p.m. And to end on a good note, February 18th is President's Day, which means no school. For those of you with weekend plans, remember to wear a coat. The weather this weekend will be ranging from high 30s to high 50s. Friday will have a high of 37 and a low of 27, while Saturday is a little warmer with a high of 49 and a low of 34. Although it's said to be a 30% chance of showers. Sunday will be much warmer, with the last 2 days with a high of 58 and a low of 40, and will mostly be sunny with a 0% chance of rain. That's all for the weather, so enjoy your weekend.
Last Thursday, the boys lost 50-75 against Fayette. The girls also lost 42-63 against Fayette. Then on Friday, the boys won on the road 68-46 against Macon Road. The girls also got the 54-32 win with Taylor Beasley and Bethany Berger scoring 32 combined points. On Saturday, the boys played the Memphis homeschool team and lost 51-44. The girls were victorious on Tuesday against Rossville with the score of 41-33. Bethany was the leading scorer with 13 points. Even with Matt Moody's 17 points, the boys still fell short to Rossville with a final score of 53-57. Tonight will be camo out as we take on St. George's at 6 and 7:30. Monday will be the last home game, and it will be senior night. The games are at 6 and 7:30. It will also be frat night.
We'll be right back. How has y'all's senior year been so far?
Well, it's been pretty good.
We've had close games.
Yeah. How is being a captain different, and what responsibility do you have to take?
Well, we get a lot more pressure from the coach, and when the whole team's messing up, we get blamed for it. Take responsibility,
yeah.
Get Spencer. Okay, Jesse, are you considering playing basketball in college?
Well, you know, me and Braxton, as a tandem, are getting offers from many colleges.
Coach Cal called the other day. No biggie.
But we don't think we're going to, we're not about that life, so we're just going to settle down in college.
Braxton, what advice would you give to the upcoming seniors?
Let's see. Put more work in the off season. That'd probably be best. Motivate as the freshmen.
Good morning, everyone. Hope everybody is having a wonderful day. I'm hoping that you will join me in a word of prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, I want to thank you for this day. I pray that we can just submit to you, Lord, and know that you are in control of our lives, Lord. And I pray that we can just thank you for everything that you've given us. And I pray that we can know that everything that happens to us, it all comes from you, Lord. In your name we pray. Amen. I have a verse for you from Proverbs chapter 17, verse 28. Even a fool is thought wise if he keeps silent, and discerning if he holds his tongue.
That's all we have for you today. Thanks for watching the RBC.